the group. Do you know what I mean? Out. We worried about that earlier on in the season, yeah. But you know, that's the main thing. We're through. What do you think Ralph learnt today from the squad players? What can he take from that?
Some positives, some negatives, right? What I would say is I'm never going to try and predict a Ralph Rangnick 11 ever again.
Like, I know, we didn't see that coming.
Man, who had Matic at centre-back? Who had Donny in a lone pivot? Who had, like... There were so many decisions where I was like, what is going on? I saw the team, I was like, I can't even pick a formation out of that. I think it's 4-2-1-3. And then I was like, I just can't even figure it out.
It was a 4-1-2-3.
4-1-2-3.
Yeah, it was like Lingard and Mata as the 2-8s, Donny sitting.
I couldn't figure out whether Mata was a 6 or an 8. Like,
yeah,
he kept on dropping back.
Both, yeah,
it was weird. Yeah, positives and negatives, mate. We can go through them, but I think Ahmad was a positive when he was playing early on. I think Shaw was a positive as well. Mm. I thought Shaw was decent early on.
Do you think that was enough from him to say, okay, I know you've seen Telles, Ralph, but, you know, I'm here. I'm the number one, but, you know.
I think so. Cheeky little assist.
Yeah.
Thought he looked good going forward and at the back. I think he was good on the ball, which is important in the Rangnick team, right? So I think he's probably done enough to warrant his start. We have spoke about that recently. We thought that Dalot might be putting more pressure on Wan-Bissaka.
Yeah.
Rather than Shaw on Telles. I think Shaw's done enough.
Yeah.
I think he has, yeah.
On the other side of the pitch, Wan-Bissaka, talk to me about his performance.
Not done enough, man. Defensively, out of position a lot. Yes, tackling, I've talked about it before, he spends so much, like, he must have, like, so many grass stains on his arse, right? The guy's on the floor all the time. He's always out of position. Going forward, he just rushes decisions. He never looks confident on the ball. His crossing is average at best. And I think it's Dalot's spot to lose now. It really is. I don't see him taking that spot back at all.
Especially after the last game against Palace. It wasn't actually until after the game that I realised Wan-Bissaka was actually on the bench.
Yeah.
Like, I thought he was still injured with the hand thing, and then I realised at the end that actually, no, it was just Ralph saying, I prefer Dalot.
Yeah, like I said, Dalot and Telles have both been signed as backup and competition, but at the end of the day, they're making serious stands for first team places, and Dalot should, and rightfully so, deserves to start the next game at Norwich. Mm.
Do you think that formation that we saw there was a reflection of the players he had available, or do you think actually, because that is something that Ralph could actually employ with the first 11, because that formation there was something we were crying out with under Ollie. Remember we were saying play one sitting, yeah, whether it's Fred or whether it's Donny, whether it's Matic, whoever it is, and play Bruno and one other ahead of that. We have been crying out for that formation. Do you think that's something he could go with?
It's a funny one, man, because everyone's like, Rangnick's all about picking people in their best positions, right?
Yeah.
So when it came to it, I was like, oh, he's picking Donny. I saw Donny's name on the team sheet. I was like, he's playing in one of the two tens, right?
Yeah,
I was like,
exactly.
100% he's playing there. And then he plays him sitting. And I know Donny did that interview a while back where he was like, I can play in a 6, I can play in 8, I can play in a 10. But I think that's because he knew that Ollie played with 2 6s and 1 10, and he was never getting in ahead of Bruno.
Yeah.
We all know Donny's best position is further forward. We all know he's better as a 10 than a 6. So does Rangnick know he's better at a 10 and a 6?
Mm.
I don't know. So did he play that formation because of the players available? I don't know, to be honest. It was a bit of a weird one. Maybe he's still in the trial stage, and he's testing stuff out. He's seeing what he can do with the players he's got available. I tell you what, I go on about him all the time, but boy, did we miss Fred today.
Mm.
Like, man, we just miss someone tenacious who gets about him in field. Like, second half especially, weren't anywhere near them. It was kind of a game of two halves. I know it was 1-1 at half-time, but we controlled it the majority of the first half. I mean, if we'd have played our first-team strikers, that game would have been out of sight. Like,
yeah,
the chances that Alanga and Ahmad and Mata, yeah, and everyone had. Like, you give Ronaldo or Cavani them, it's lights out, right? Mm. It's game over. So I thought we controlled it quite well. They scored a worldie, fair play.
Yeah.
But second half, it was all
there. Does that show how instrumental he is then? Because like you said, in that midfield, you're looking at a midfield of Mata, Lingard and Donny. None of those are going to be as energetic as Fred and get about the pitch as Fred and get in people's faces like Fred and the ball recoveries. And bring McTominay into that as well. I know McTominay takes a lot of stick, but in terms of having those two combative players in there, does that show why maybe Ralph Rangnick did kind of stick with those two?
I think so, mate. And it's not just Ralph Rangnick. And I know we can slate Ollie, but it's Ollie. It's Mourinho. It's every manager picks Fred and McTominay.
Mm.
And we can group them together and say they're bad and all this, but they're solid.
Mm.
And they do a job in certain games. And we played Mata and Donny and Lingard. Can't you group those three together?
It's not
nowhere near physical enough.
Mm.
Nowhere near combative enough. And realistically, they just got overrun in that midfield by a very, very average young boys team.
Mm.
I know it was a kind of a dead rubber. Like, when you sub your goalkeeper in the second half,
exactly,
it's a dead rubber, like, it means nothing.
And it's a chance to look. Ralf Rangnick, he's not going to be able to look at these players in the Premier League and say, oh, you know what, it's Norwich away. Let me just quickly see what Amaka do. Let me quickly see what Tom Heaton. He can't do that. It was a chance for him to just look at his players today, wasn't it? And just assess what he's got there and have a look at it.
I think, realistically, the players that have potentially got a chance, you go through the team, like Henderson, potentially, if De Gea drops in form. Wan-Bissaka had a chance to fight. Bailly, maybe, sure. And then you go forward, Greenwood. I don't think Matic is. I don't think Mata is. Donny, obviously. Don't think Ahmad is. Don't think Alanga is.
They're not going to play too much more this season.
They're not going to play loads of football, no. They're in the 25, and then and obviously great for the young lads to get on as well.
Going forward, the draw obviously hasn't been done yet. I'm not saying to you, I'm not going to ask you, are we going to win the Champions League? It's a stupid question.
Mate,
but
ask me.
No, I'm not going to let you do that to yourself. I'm not going to do it.
Clip it up.
I'm going to ask you, what are you expecting in this run? How far can we go? Is this team, our best team obviously, capable of going deep into the Champions League and winning it?
Mate, we are 16-1, and I know that because I backed us before. Yeah? So,
are you ready for it on? Yeah,
I'm not messing about, man. Like, Di Matteo came in, Chelsea won the Champions League. Yeah. Tuchel came in, Chelsea won the Champions League.
Why not?
Man Utd's coming in, United winning the Champions League. Clip it up, winning it.
You actually do think we are going to win it?
No, I think we've got a chance. Like, cup competitions, right? I'll sit on the fence now. Yeah.
He's reeling it back in.
Cup competitions, right?
Yeah, yeah.
There's always a chance. Old Trafford's been booming recently. Like, where I see it, like, the atmosphere's mint. I think the fans are behind Rangnick. If we can unite the fan base, the squad is very good. I've said, like, it's probably the second best squad in the league after chat. I really do like our squad. The players are very, very talented. If we can... We've got this sports psychologist now, which is a big thing. Like, honestly, I really believe that's big in sport. Like, having the right mentality to approach and the winning mentality. You can go far in a cup competition, man. And nothing beats Old Trafford under the lights on a Wednesday night. And I fancy a trip abroad. Is it Istanbul this year?
Yeah.
I
didn't allow myself to think where the final could be. I went to a final last year in a very cold Poland, and I don't want to remember it. Do you know what I mean? I thought, let me just think of where the final is. Maybe if we get to the semis, I might think of that. Who was your man of the match finish off?
You know what? First half, I was going to give it to Greenwood, but I think Bailly was very good. I think he's... I mean, I spoke about Maguire last week and I don't want to bring it up, but is he our fourth best centre-back on form at the moment? Because Varane, Lindelof and Bailly all look better than him. Bailly looks superb tonight. And that's not me saying that Maguire won't start. Politics comes into it, right?
Yeah,
£80 million, captain of the club.
Yeah.
I agree with you, like... Rangnick, here for 6 months, isn't going to come in and change the captain of the club. He's not here going forward, so he's not going to do that. I strongly believe that. So Maguire will play. But there's a strong case for Bailly and Varane.
And that Bailly thing has never really gone away. Like, every time he comes in and has these little cameos, I think a lot of fans have called for him to get more game time or, like, a consistent run, but it never seems to happen.
Listen, he's got a mistake in him. He's got a red card in him, but he's also got a last-ditch block in him, as we saw today. Like, there was one instance at the Stretford End where I think he slid in and then he blocked something last minute, and I'm like, it's so Eric Bailly. Like, he basically did the splits to block it, and I was like, what is going on?
Yeah, he's nuts.
He's absolutely nuts, mate. So, yeah, he was man of the match, but shout-out to Mason, because the finish was unbelievable.
Yeah.
As the chant goes, dynamite, mate. Scores him with his left foot, scores him with his right. That's, like, Mason's fucking mint, mate. He should get in the team more often. But, yeah.
Eric Bailly, man of the match.
Yeah, man. Lex.
Love.
Always.
Thanks, man.
Thanks, man.